Hello, welcome back. After having cooled off my anger about this room, I'm ready to come back and give it another try. Okay, right, that's the exit room. That's why it's magenta. So I just spent some time on my own figuring out the particular magic sequence which happens to work and get me here. Some people have claimed... Let's see if I can execute this correctly. Some people have claimed that there is a linchpin of sorts in this room. I certainly have not found one. This is how I... the way that I found it works. If I used a linchpin in there and didn't realize it, please let me know. If you know of a different one, please let me know. Although I guess I can also just look at demos after clearing that. Ortho squares. Okay, so there's a quicker way to do it, at the very least. Ortho squares, I find, change the rules of the game in a way that makes it unfamiliar and much less fun. Because so many of my survival strategies in this game rely on being able to move diagonally. Apparently looking at demos is a controversial thing for some people. The idea being that somebody can optimize something most of the way, somebody else will look at their demo, copy it, except for one small change that makes it slightly faster. So maybe I should start looking at, like, not the number one demo? I don't know. Maybe it doesn't matter. So show me the other magic sequence that's apparently three moves quicker. Pretty similar to what I used, actually. So what was the essential difference? Show me that again. That's very similar to what I did. I don't know if... I don't understand. I don't understand what I'm supposed to understand about this room to make it make sense. The only thing I knew how to do here was just keep trying until something somehow worked. Yeah, because usually I can apply some form of reasoning to even stuff like horde management. Well, sometimes I can apply it to horde management, but not in that room. That just did not work for me. Anyway, right, so exit level. Up here is the way I want to go. I wonder if this is the last level. All of the others, I seem to recall, had their stairway in the entrance room. So since this one is in a different place, I feel like it might be different. Which orb does what? Which will inform me which way I need to face my sword. Alright, is this not just a simple matter of... This is set up to be backtrackable, definitely. So at the very least, there's something past these stairs. Yes, go away. So this looks like a very simple briar race. What complication could there be? That. What? Let's see. How could waiting ever be of benefit to me? Seems like it couldn't. Let's see, so that only closes with that. That opens with this. Using that orb first doesn't make any sense. Briars will destroy orbs without activating them. What if I just leave and then re-enter from the stairs? Is that a thing I can do? I believe it is. Ha! What an interesting way to do a room. Is that actually what I'm supposed to do? Level 6.5! This doesn't feel like any of the levels I've been on before. The stairs were short too. Heh, maybe this is where all the tiny bureaucrats hang out. Hoo-hoo, all these years below haven't dulled my wit in the least. Okay. Those stairs are green! Still gotta do some things before I go past those arrows. Oh, there are arrows, huh? So, wait. Starting from here will not help me. So no, that was not at all the solution. Also, I'm not trapped. Oh wait, yeah, it will. Yeah, this is how I do it. Briars are not involved in killing the roach, that's the key. Ha! That was different. I've never seen... a solution like that used before. Alright. I didn't step on that checkpoint. Let's do that. Okay, great. Warning, force arrows ahead. Thank you.
Probably won't be able to get back after this.
I can always restore if I missed any secrets. Level 7. Seems like there's no way back now. Gotta move onward. I hope this dungeon has a back exit. And while I'm hoping, maybe it has a larder and some piping hot leaf juice, too. Okay, so it is another full level, seemingly.
A man with pointy thing comes here. This our home, I says it. We gives you a bad toothache.
This is your home? Why are goblins living here?
A man with pointy thing comes here.
Uh-huh. So I have the option of waiting. What are you doing? You're a scripted character. Character mimic. Real decoy. What am I seeing here? What happens if I wait? Okay, bombs blow up. This pressure plate clears and that closes. And nothing opens it, so... I can't stop a decoy from stepping on those fuses, as far as I can tell. So my priority is to step on this pressure plate. Got it. Or get a goblin to do it, maybe. Okay. So probably want sword like what, this? Thank you, goblin. And now you're trapped. Okay, does the other goblin perhaps kill a serpent? I wonder if I needed both of them. Okay, I do need both of them. Other goblin goes there at some point, but I think maybe he needs to kill a serpent first. There's a sec- oh, okay. So no, Roach needs to kill serpent. Fine. I can make that happen. Let's see. If I want to walk a goblin downward, I can certainly do it like this, but that's too slow. Other sword orientations that would allow me to do that. That was no better. No, I mean, this seems like it makes the most sense. Potion noises. Be prepared for a bunch of those, apparently. How do I move a goblin diagonally away from me? I don't remember there being a good way to do that. Oh, hey. That somehow worked. Why did that work? So since Goblin prefers north and west, it decided to go around the obstacle that way, and then the exact same thing happened here. Okay. I'm pretty sure this room would not work if rotated or mirrored. At least some ways. Was that a Roach Queen? Yeah? Huh. Right, I need her. Seems very simple, except that Roach is going to go down there. Well, I can wait for it to fill up, I guess. And I think I'm going to have to, because I don't get the option. I couldn't, like, pull a Roach out of here and possibly... No. No getting in there. Alright, so just be patient. And then I have to do it again. Man. At a different time? No, wait. Oh yeah, that worked. Cool. You are going to do a thing. You're scripted to go and do that, huh? So I need to do my cleanup quickly. Is this what I want? Yes. Oh, wait. Goblin has to stay. Uh-oh. Okay, so this character here has made things a little bit more complicated. Wait, I'm not safe there. Why did you... Okay, because of turn order. Your turn order is lower, so you moved there and blocked this one. Otherwise, you would go down there like I wanted you to. And moving like that did not change anything. I was one turn short? Right, because doors close after everything moves. So yes, I was one turn short. Alright, I'm sure I can find a turn in here somewhere. Not there. Unless I turn my sword. This is what I already did. There were some differences there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, that was fine. Okay, cool. This hold is doing some things with scripting that I'm not used to seeing. Power token. Again, it's doing things with the power token that I wanted to see more of, and I am, so I'm happy that it's using those, because they're an interesting element. Oh, but I'm disarmed. Step there to rearm and kill Water Skipper. An aumtlich will be in the way at some point. So I tap that and get out here. How do you open? Aumtlich has to stand on pressure plates. Cool, okay. I say cool. I'm going to be angry at this momentarily, probably. Because Aumtlich, when disarmed, are quite obnoxious. Alright, so how is this? You have to stand... someplace for some length of time. Let's see. How would that ever happen? Well, for one thing, I need him on the other side of this. To do this, I need to do that, and then... Ooh. Right. Aumtlich manipulation is kind of interesting. Okay, I got that accomplished. Except I didn't. I got this accomplished. So that's something. Cool. What's this? That lets him out. This is necessary. Okay, so I need to get to that next. How? I guess similarly to what I already did. Okay, this isn't so bad. This won't work. This won't work. This is not going to work. So if that doesn't work, then I guess I want him here instead? Which means I need to move him laterally. Horizontally. And that's going to be a problem, isn't it? Yeah, moving an aumtlich horizontally in this kind of setup. Yeah, I remember. It's hard. I need to, like, do it from here or here. Yeah, you can just keep... Well, you won't keep turning. Maybe if you come in from over here, you're not aligned where I need you. So I guess I need to, this is not right. No, not that. Kinda had an idea here. It won't work though. Oh wait, maybe it did. Yes, that did what I wanted it to do. Now if I do this and that, does that do everything I need? No, because he still beams me. That's not helpful in any way. How would this ever happen? The way that would happen, I suppose, would be... well, if he's already there, and he has to turn the maximum amount of times... Hey, I see. Wait. Why did that not... I bumped the... Oh, right, I couldn't bump the orb because I was stunned. Ah, this is cool, I like this room. This is a refreshing change of pace. you toggle that. Will I have time? Not quite. Alright, so aumtlich needs to get a little farther away. I've learned to like these guys a lot more than I used to. I mean, I never really hated them, but there was that one room in... I guess it was the second sky, where I had some major trouble with them, and was very unhappy about it. But I'm having a lot of fun with this puzzle, at least. This one's cool. You're in the way. Where do I need to place you? Ah. I guess just having learned the moves that I need to use to manipulate them just makes everything much nicer. That won't work. He's facing his beam up there. I guess I just shove him in the corner over here, maybe? Somehow? Wait, something's not right here. Right, I go around this way. Mm-hmm. And then what? I guess this... And then this... And that. Okay, he's in the corner. Well, as in the corner as he's gonna get for now. That's not helping. Alright, so what's the idea? Stick him here, maybe? Or... yeah, that would never happen. Oh, hey! There we go! I don't know if that's intended, but it sure does work. That's cool. It's like it's a room about aumtlich and closed door... standing on closed door interactions. Oh, hey! I see you! And just like that, my mood is back up to its normal chipperness. Ah. This room somehow looks vaguely familiar. What am I doing? So if I were to just kill these guys, that would not be open. To open that, I need to open this. To open that, somebody needs to be standing there. Or a mirror needs to go there. Pushing a mirror in here. To there is no problem. Tunnel. Why are you a tunnel? You're a tunnel so a monster can't step on you and a mirror can't be pushed onto you. That's closed by that. Why? Ooh. Aumtlich beams light fuses. So I can't let them do, say, that. That'd be the easy way to clear the room. But then I can't get out. Alright. Okay, so if I were pushing a mirror in here, I'd like to... let's see. The other thing I can do with a mirror is put out a fuse. Or that. That also works. I would like to just get rid of these guys and mess with the mirror in here to see if it's... Let's see. So I'd push it in there with my body, and then I'm trapped. I would push it in here with my sword, then... then I can't actually push it any further there. So I don't quite get this. Like, if there is no mirror here... I can walk in here and walk out. But if there's a mirror here and here, and I need to avoid pushing it there, because that's irretrievable, then I have a problem. I can't blow up this bomb. An aumtlich can't help me blow up that bomb. That closes that. Yeah, so this is complicated. Oh, wait a second. Here's a thing that opens. I step on that first. Then Beethro can get in and out. Okay, got it. Alright, so I just have to kill aumtlich without setting off these bombs. I found this, which seems helpful. So what if I just sort of sit here and deal with you for a bit? You set off that bomb like a jerk. Of course you do. That would let you free and you would set off that bomb like a jerk. But not if my sword's... If my sword is there, they still light the fuse. Weird. That is... an obscure behavior that I hope nobody has built a puzzle around, because... it's weird. Okay, accomplished. I remember hearing that... Let's see, I think I'm running... Yeah, this is DROD 5.1. Apparently a change that broke a whole bunch of demos was that Beethro's sword over a why did I do that? Not paying enough attention. Beethro's sword over a rot golem corpse used to reflect aumtlich beams, but now it doesn't anymore. Fuse being lit while under his sword seems like another thing like that that could totally change someday. Or maybe that's intended, but anyway, it's weird. I guess, like, what, the sword gets hot? I don't know, what is an aumtlich beam? What does it do to you exactly? Why do you freeze when it touches you? Now hang on, what am I doing with this mirror? I'm doing this with this mirror. No, I'm not. That bomb is in the way. Mirrors don't go into tunnels. The bomb blows me up. And then I'm trapped if I do this. Well, not exactly. Oh, here we go. That's all I needed. Simpler than I was making it. Cool. That was a nice secret. Look which room I'm saving for last, again. I don't know why it's always this one, but for some reason it's always that one. Apologies for any background noise. I'm just noticing there are some very loud birds out my window, but windows are open because it's hot. One evil eye to kill. Conquer token to step on. Toggle with that. Oh no, a platform. Oh no, a mimic platform. Oh dear. Do I need to make this mimic move the mirror over here for something? To be on that? Let's see. Okay, so yes, the something... has to sit there. Why couldn't it just be the mimic? I guess because I would never get to this conquer token. Oh, wait. Mimic goes in here? Yeah, mimic goes in there. Beether goes... Okay, good, good. So I don't have to have the mimic move the platform around. So, does that just get my sword stuck? Is that what I'm seeing? Yeah, that only opens with that orb. I have to pick a diagonal sword orientation and stick with it this whole time. So the only ones that would allow me to get this mirror out are this one and this one, right? Because I would never be able to get the mirror out of there with this or that. Yeah, so it has to be either this or this. This seems better than this for killing the evil eye, which I'll have to do eventually somehow. So let's try this then. Prepare for orb noises. The problem is I kind of need the other one to move the mirror around. Okay, so let's say maybe it's the other one. Stepping on that right away should ensure a first place tie, I think. Not that I care that much in a hold like this. Wait, what? Do I want perhaps this? Yeah, seems like I want that. Okay. And then just get some distance on him so I can... What? Oh, well, why don't I just do this? There we go. Don't need to use my sword. I have another tool. Hey, first place tie. Okay, maybe I will get to this room. Ooh, guards. Ooh, speed potion. Are these Beethro voodoo dolls? Probably.
Squad, get him.
All right, speed potion,
squad,
guards.
Get him.
Right, the turn I drink the speed potion. I have never fought a guard with a speed potion before. That's probably not true, but it might be. Also, there are wubbas. Oh boy. Also have a time limit. Oh boy. I'm not being anywhere near quick enough. This demands much more efficiency. Guards! Stop doing that! Beat your voodoo doll died. Alright, so I need to do something different.
Squad, get him.
Oh, I get it. I need to go for this and ignore the guards. At least as much as I'm able to. Just cut a path through somehow. That was not... maybe I do that? No, not exactly. See, none of this gets me where I need to be. But I need to be there very quickly. No way out of this one, huh? Yeah, none of those squares are safe. No sword turns can help me. I can do that, but big deal. Okay, so... So none of... Okay, only this orientation lets me go straight forward like that. But then you do this, and that's not what I want. If I do that... And if I swing this way, you'll just step that way and kill me. And if I do that, you just stay in place and nothing happens. If I do this... somehow it works, because of turn order. You turned your sword before you were able to move forward and kill me. Okay. I certainly can't wait. Well, this approach is going better now. So maybe I didn't want to do it that other way. No, that's nowhere near fast enough.
Squad, get him.
So it's going to be... those will grow every turn, right? Every full turn. So number of half turns is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I can only waste 2 half turns on the way there. Yikes.
Squad, get him.
How? Like, this feels great except for what happens right here. Those start in this formation.
Squad.
Huh. I just found something. If Bithro has an expression on his face because of what's around him, and I press spacebar, he goes back to neutral. Ha! I never knew that. So my options here are... either step southeast and wait. I survive that. Step southeast and turn this way. I survive that. And there's nothing else survivable that goes forward. If I go back a little bit, this guy's gonna kill me. If I go back this way, obviously his friend kills me. If I turn and stay, I die. If my sword is another way, is there any other...
Squad, get him.
Let's try... no.
Squad, get him.
So hang on, he dies. I need to move forward a lot faster than this allows. Like, this seems like the only sword orientation that makes sense, but, But it doesn't make sense. To survive this, I have to turn this way. Turning that way means, like, I just don't have enough moves for this. They are very effectively blocking this hallway. I guess, okay, so here's a
squad,
change I can make. I don't have to enter there. What if I enter here?
Squad, get him.
That might make a difference.
Squad.
Let's see. Wait, did that? Oh, I see. No, he moved, then he moved. I thought they had both moved their swords into me to kill me. This is promising. Kinda. And not really, though. So those are all death. Wait a second. There's a room clear gate there. I'm not trying to get to this pressure plate. Except, well, no. I need a guard alive. Because of the, or a water skipper, well, Yeah, no, I have... this guy is to put pressure on to me to reach this pressure plate immediately. This guy is to put pressure onto me to clear the room quickly. Okay, so I tried that orientation there. Let's try this Squad, orientation here. Doesn't seem too great. Let's try this orientation here.
Squad, get him.
Ooh, this is better. This is kinda better. There are things I like about this. There are things I like very much about this. Ooh, yes, 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 I think that's it. Oh, water skipper, no! Oh, why? So I have to face, I have to end with my sword facing the other way. Alright, that's fine. I can find a way to do that, probably. Did that do it, or was I too slow? I was too slow. Alright, so what did I do? I did this, I stepped here. I did this. And then that just wasn't quite good enough because of the water skipper. Now the other thing is, I could arrive a turn earlier. If I saved another turn, this water skipper wouldn't kill me, because I'd be on a half turn. Alright, so that's another option. If I could save another turn... Alright, what did I do? Step, step, step. I waited when I did this. What if I don't wait? That happens and that's no good. Waiting is better because it puts me up here. Can't step there. That feels like the best I'm gonna do that with that arrangement, at least. So one turn faster or a northeast sword orientation would do it. Okay, let's try flipping that vertically.
Squad, get him.
Feels the same. Okay, so it felt the same right up until that. Can't do that, can't do that. Could wait. No, nothing about this is any good. I mean, I'm not even... Yeah, I'm a full turn behind.
Squad, get
him. Yes, yes, squad, get him. There shouldn't ever be a reason not to kill a guard. If I waited here, though... wait, that is what I do. I wait there. This one will kill me. Though you would move the way I needed you to move, wouldn't you? Oh, hey. Well, that was magical. Thanks, turn order. Alright, so now I'm racing for this. This is pretty cool. I'm on the opposite side, now just kill quickly. I didn't kill quickly enough. Wait, hang on, that's over a pit. I did kill quickly enough. Cool. Now, wubbas! Wubbas were not a problem. Neat! Alright, I did it! Not entirely happy with the turn order shenanigans I had to pull there to get that to work, but that was fine. Level 8! Mithra felt great relief when he saw the long stairs going up on the 8th level. That seems like an exit. The stairs go up. I'm guessing the stuff I'm looking for is here. Alright. Yeah, this looks like another full level. This hold is longer than I expected. How does this work? Oh, trapdoor gate. Got it. Interesting. This one is actually ordered, unlike the others. All right, great. So, level 8 next time. I got the last little bit of level 6 done and level 7, and I feel good about myself. Okay, I'll see you next time for what's almost certainly the final level.